Hi everyone, welcome to this Sunday's streaming concert at home by Camerata Pacifica. My name is Warren Jones and I'm the principal pianist for the group, and I occupy the Robert and Mercedes Eicholtz chair in piano. I want to wish everyone a happy Father's Day and a happy solstice, and I especially want to send good wishes for everyone for the summer ahead. I hope it's a good time for all of us. The first piece that we're going to hear today is the Adagio in B minor by Mozart. This is a late composition of Mozart's. It lasts about 9 minutes. It's for solo piano, and it's very beguiling because during most of the time that I'm playing, my hands are only playing one note a piece. There are very few chords in the piece. And basically, we're going to hear a conversation, a musical conversation, between my two hands. I've been enthralled by this piece since 1971, when I heard my teacher at New England Conservatory play it on a faculty recital. Its simplicity and the directness of the music is fairly astonishing. I hope you enjoy it.
Thank you.
Isn't that an amazing piece of music? After the performance that evening, the audience was hesitant to clap. I had the feeling that they were sitting there really thinking about this amazing, mysterious piece of music that they had just heard. I was very gratified by that. The next performance that we're going to hear today is of the Sonata for Piano and Cello in E minor by Brahms. And I will be joined by Ani Aznavoorian. Ani plays with such great instinct and integrity and a very warm sense of communication, both with me and with the audience and the public that was there that evening. The piece is in three movements. The first is a very brooding allegro in which the melody comes up from the bottom of the cello at the beginning, and it seems to want to rise throughout the movement, but somehow it always falls back and falls back and falls back, and then the movement is over. The second movement is a country dance with a notable hitch in the rhythm for the dance step. It's very charming and fun to play. And the third movement is all energy all the time, this time starting in the bottom of the piano. And this time the energy will not be denied. And it just overflows with vitality. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you again, Ani, for such a wonderful performance. It is always a privilege and pleasure to make music with you. Thanks very much. The pieces that we're going to hear now are four songs by Walter Rabl, his Opus 5. They will be performed by Andrew Garland and Ani Aznavoorian and myself. These four songs were written early in Rabl's life. He had won a composition competition in which Brahms was the head of the jury, and Brahms had said that Rabl was the next great Germanic composer. Unfortunately, he only composed through Opus 15 because he was offered a job as principal conductor at the Vienna State Opera, a position which he accepted, and because of that, he gave up his composition activities and devoted his life entirely to the opera house. The four poems share certain characteristics and qualities. The first song is entitled Too Late. It talks about autumn sunshine and a last butterfly that is flitting around several flowers looking for nectar. But the poet says, in the same way that the butterfly is too late for the flower's nectar, he was too late for love earlier in his life. The second song speaks of a house deep in the woods with moonlight shining on it. But the house is shut up incredibly tightly so that nothing can escape from it. The brook behind the house murmurs. It speaks of love. It speaks of mysteries. It speaks of times long ago. And it brings withered roses mysteriously back to life. But those roses are from a time long gone by. The third song is about a violinist. He says that he plays frequently on this corner. He has met a lot of women in his life. He's kissed a lot of people. He's had a lot of passion. He's known a lot of girlfriends, but he never had a wife and he never had a family. And now it's too late to have that. It will not happen. The fourth song is about a young soldier. They told him that the war would be short, that glory would be great. And now he is lying in the mud, wounded fatally, and he feels the hand of death creeping up on him. He asks, where is my homeland? My homeland is where my mother is. My homeland is where my girlfriend is. They know me there. They love me there. But I was poor there, and I'm poor here, and soon I will be dead and forgotten. But my mother and my girlfriend will remember me. And they will be sad when they find out what happened. Thank you.
Ein kühler mansion rot and wohnt, hat manch lustiges Liedel gespielt. Doch jetzt bin ich alt und mein Herz ist wund, es hat die sacht. Des Todes grausen gehand. Thank you.
tristes Ruhm sein, was kümmert mich so pein, ob sein dies Land noch zu gehören.
Thanks very much for being here with us today. You know, the community of listeners that we have at Camerata Pacifica, our audience, whether in person or watching this stream every Sunday afternoon, is the vital component that makes our communication as artists complete. We appreciate you very much, and we're very glad that you're here with us each week. I want to say thank you very much to Adrian Spence for having the vision and the energy to put together all this material and to put it out every week on the internet so that we can maintain our communication and our contact with you. And I can tell you, speaking for all my colleagues, that we look forward to the day when we can be back together in person again, sharing the joy of music together. Thanks again for being here. We hope to see you next week at the same time and the same channels. Bye-bye.